you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for the Lord is good and worthy to be praised. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for the Lord is good and worthy to be praised. As we drop the baggage and travel lightly, we know that God is able to put lightness in our feet and clapping in our hands, because we give his name the thanks and the praise that is truly, truly worthy of. That's why we can give him thanks. That's why we can give him praise, because he's worthy of all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. It's truly worthy and given unto him. So we thank him today. We thank him for blessing us. We thank him for keeping us. In Jesus' name, now you have been called to worship.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us pray. Father God, it's once and again that we come before you. First of all, saying thank you, God. We thank you for another Lord's Day, God. We thank you for allowing us to see this day, God. We thank you for our rest last night, Father. We thank you for touching us this morning with your finger of love. And it was just because of your love and your grace, God, that you allowed us to rise again this morning to see the bright sunshine. Yeah, it's cool outside, Father God, but we thank you for allowing us to feel that coolness. God, we love you today. We ask that you show up and show out in this service today, oh God, for there is none like you, oh Lord. There is none like you, O Lord. There is none like you, O Lord. Father God, we thank you. We thank you for Jesus today, Father God, that you allowed him to walk this earth, God, to die and to rise again on that third day so that we might have the right to the tree of life, Father God. God, we thank you for Jesus this morning, Father. God bless Jesus this morning. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Father God, as we continue with this service this morning, we ask that you bless this little house on the hill called Macedonia New Life Church, oh God, and all of us that are dwelling in here today, though. Those that are on the way, Father God, those that cannot make it for whatever reason, Father God, we ask that you bless in a mighty way. Father God, we ask that you bless our pastor in his absence today, him and the First Lady, Father God, as they take a well-needed vacation, Father God. We ask that you give them peace, give them rest, and give them fun, oh Lord. And when they come back, Father God, give them a word from on high, because we know it'll be a mighty time in Macedonia. So, Father God, right now we thank you. Thank you for all that will participate today, oh Lord. We ask that you bless them in a special way, Father God, from the back of the church to the front of the church, Father God, from pew to pew, from heart to heart, from breast to breast. Bless everyone that will participate today, oh God. Give them a special anointing from on high, Father. We ask that you continue to bless Macedonia. Bless the man servant that you sent our way to deliver the message this morning, Father God. Give him a special word from on high, God. Let him down into your storehouse of knowledge. And when he come up, let him come up saying, thus says the Lord. Father God, we love you today. We bind all evil spirits today, Father God. We bind all negativity today, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. We rebuke that in the name of Jesus. We will praise the Lord. As for this house on the hill, Macedonia New Life Church, we will praise the Lord. Not because of, but in spite of. Father God, we thank you this morning. We bless your holy name. Love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We say hallelujah and praise be to the Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, we ask, and we believe. Amen.
The scripture for today comes from the book of Exodus. The book of Exodus, the chapter is 14, and we will begin at the 21st verse. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, And all that night the Lord drove the sea back with a strong east wind and turned it into dry land. The waters were divided, and the Israelites went through the sea on dry ground, with a wall of water on their right and on their left. The Egyptians pursued Pharaoh's horses and chariots, and horsemen followed them into the sea. During the last watch of the night, the Lord looked down from the pillar of fire and cloud at the Egyptian army and threw it into confusion. He jammed the wheels of their chariots so that they had difficulty driving. And the Egyptians said, "Let's get away from the Israelites. The Lord is fighting for them against Egypt." The Lord's word for God's people. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord together. Come on and let us bless the Lord together. The Bible says, "I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth." So if I got some believers that can hear me this morning, that's willing to let the praises be in your mouth continually, come on and let us bless the Lord together. If you're watching us or listening over live stream, or you're on Facebook, or wherever you are, you're in this sanctuary, we want to take a moment to bless the Lord at all times and let his praise continually be in our mouth. With your hands, come on and bless him. With your feet, you can bless him. With your heart, you can bless him. With everything that you have in you, come on and let's bless the Lord. The Bible says, let everything that hath breath praise ye the Lord. So if you're breathing this morning, come on and let's bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on and bless the Lord. Hallelujah. I will bless the Lord. Hallelujah. At all times. Hallelujah. And we say thank you, Lord. We say thank you. Hallelujah. Yeah, God.
Boys, I praise him with everything in me. I God does. But do you ever stop to think about all the things that God kept you from? Yeah. All the things that God didn't allow to happen. Yeah. And when we think about those things, sometimes we think about it as the things that we wanted to happen. But we've got to think about the fact that God knows best. Yeah. God knows what's best for all of us all the time. Yeah. God is ever present. God is omnipotent. God is omniscient. God is all-knowing. He knows everything. He knows all about it before you even bring it to God. So don't neglect thanking God for even the things that He didn't allow to happen. The people that He's kept away from you. The people that He's kept you away from. The situations that He's kept you out of for your good. The Bible says in everything, in everything, in everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Give thanks. Come on, tell God thank you. Tell God thank you. Tell God in your own way. Tell God thank you. Tell God thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for all that you've done, for the things that you didn't allow to happen. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. I remember what you did for me last year, so I know you'll do it again. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Lord, I know I wanted that thing so badly, but you kept it from me because you knew what was best for me. Thank you, Lord. So today we give thanks in all things. In all things we give thanks. Bless His name.
what the Lord has done for us.
And now,
let the weak say, I am strong.
Let the poor say,
I am rich. Because of what?
Give thanks with a grateful heart.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks for He has given. Jesus Christ, His Son.
Macedonia New Life Church, and to all of our worshipers, we bring you greetings from our pastor, Pastor Joel Stevenson, and First Lady Brenda Stevenson. Come let us worship, go up and worship on this first Sunday of Advent. The wonderful time and season of the year where we eagerly await the celebration of the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. On this Sunday of Advent, we celebrate the hope that we have given to us through the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Once again, we say welcome to all of you who watch either through live stream, Roku, YouTube, and Facebook. Wherever you are joining us from around the world, we welcome you. And to those of you who have joined us here in the sanctuary, we welcome you. On your screen, you will see the giving platform through which you will give your offering and tithe. We want to thank each of you for your faithful stewardship. Not a debt you owe, but a seed that you sow. And whosoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. Our two online giving platforms are Text to Give and Gilify. To those gathering in the sanctuary, if you did not have a chance to give, the way in the sanctuary are two baskets in the back, which you will give your tithes and offering, and keeping in social distance. We are still maintaining social distance as we stand in our pandemic and is in our aim to keep one another safe. Again, we say thank you for your continued faithful stewardship.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Today is Aging Gracefully Ministry anniversary, and we give thanks for God that he has allowed us to come together in the church again. We thank you. At this time, the ministry would like to honor those that we have lost. So I'm asking that if it's a family member here, would you please stand of the names that I call, and the Aging Gracefully Ministry members, please stand. And we're going to light a candle in their memory. Okay, Miss Mae Frances Rogers, Miss Minnie Scott, and Miss Ida Hamer. A life well lived. A life well lived is a precious gift of hope and strength and grace from someone who has made our world a brighter, better place. It is filled with moments of sweet and sad smiles and sometimes tears, with friendship formed and good times shared and laughter throughout the years. Miss May Frances, Miss Minnie, and Miss Ida lived a life well lived, a legacy of joy, pride, and grace. God has them in his keeping now, but their memories will forever live in our hearts. Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning,
Pastor Ron Waldon, Pastor Kim Waldon, and Rama, and everyone present today, and all who are watching via media platform. The Aging Gracefully Ministry celebrates its church anniversary on the fourth Sunday in November each year. The ministry is for church members who are 55 and older. This ministry supports the church's scholarship program. We believe in the words fellowship with laughter. In prior years, the Aging Gracefully Ministry was responsible for planting flowers in front of the church. We looked forward to that beautification project each year. Also, visitations to the church's sick and shut in their home, or at least at a rest home facility, bringing joy and sunshine through songs and prayer. Many of the members in prior years enjoyed each other's company through traveling, whether a yearly outing to Virginia Beach and stopping at a couple of stores, which included a hat store, experiencing a cruise on the Spirit of Norfolk ship, which included eating, attending a play at the Barnes Dinner Theater in Greensboro, which included eating, sponsoring a Thanksgiving luncheon and giving and inviting guests to include residents of Cedar Crest, which included eating, sponsoring a senior citizens program to provide information, which included guest speakers, performance, and eating, and the list continues and included eating. Then the pandemic came on the scene, and no more Monday meetings and eating after the meetings. No more fourth Monday birthday celebrations, which included eating. We were on the move, and prayerfully we will begin our adventures again and will be able to meet in person at some point where we can develop new agendas. So until that time, we will meet on the fourth Monday and greet each other in our personal TV monitor, one by one or three by three, depending on how many attend the Zoom meeting. And we will continue fellowshipping via Zoom, but one day we will fellowship together in person and definitely include eating. We will welcome new members, and any member of the Aging Gracefully Ministry can give you information about joining. The Aging Gracefully members believe in the power of laughter. So I will read two excerpts, and we will see about the power of laughter. The first one is, Dr. Bloom was known for miraculous cures for arthritis. He had a waiting room full of people when a little old lady completely bent over in half, shuffled in slowly, leaning on her cane. When the lady's turn came, she went into the examination room and amazingly emerged only a few minutes later, walking completely erect with her head held high. One woman still in the waiting room said, "It's a miracle. You walked in bent in half, and now you're walking erect? What did that doctor do?" She answered, "Miracle, shmiracle. He gave me a longer cane." And the last one. Two elderly couples are enjoying some friendly conversation when one of the men asked the other, "Hey, Henry, how was the memory clinic you attended last month?" "Amazing," he replies. "Well, I learned all the latest techniques in visualization, association, and the like. It made a real difference in my memory." "That's terrific. What was the name of the clinic?" Henry is embarrassed. For the life of him, he could not remember. Then a smile breaks across his face, and he asks,
What do you call that flower with the long stem and thorns? You mean a rose? Yes, that's it, he turns to his wife. Rose, what was the name of that memory clinic?
Good morning. Put glad hands together for the Aging Gracefully Ministry. Amen. Okay. Who has a presentation at this time?
Good morning, church. You know, it's a pleasure and a great opportunity to be a part of this ministry. You know, we all want to live and become old. We all want to live to get old.
Yes, sir.
You know, but it, you know, I'm talking to young, the young as well, want to live to get old. You know, to be categorized as old. You know, but the alternative there is to die. Yeah. We want to live to get old, but yeah, but we don't want to deal with the things that we have to deal with, the issues of being old. But age comes with a price.
Amen.
Comes with a price. You know, we got all these miracle drugs called anti-aging agents. What is that? An anti-aging agent. You can't stop aging if you continue to live. You can't stop the aging process. Those drugs should be called anti-not looking old age agents. Yeah, we don't want to look old. Yeah, that's why we flock to many of these agents. Many of us want to change our look by the makeup, dress, or whatever. Let me tell you what I did. I grew a beard hoping that it would say distinguished gentleman.
Come on.
And
come on.
Right now. All right.
Come on.
But the only thing it said was senior discount. Please. That was the only thing it said. Look at this beautiful group. I have a presentation here from the Aging Graceful Ministry. We hope and pray that it will be used for the upbuilding of God's kingdom.
Amen.
All right. Bless you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
All right. Thank you. To the Aging Graceful Ministry, we say we say thank you this morning.
Bless your heart. Bless your heart.
The voice this morning kind of hit home with me, so please forgive me.
Okay.
So as I look around, I only see about four or five people that shouldn't be over here sitting with this group, because most of everybody here is of age to be sitting with this group.
Say that.
And we all should be sitting over here with this group this morning.
Come on, sir.
Yeah, I only see about four or five people.
Yeah.
They shouldn't be sitting over here. So next year, first of all, we want to thank you for your contribution.
Yes, sir.
On behalf of the pastor, officers of the church, we thank you for your contribution. And pretty soon I'll start going out to eat with you ladies. And hopefully next year we'll see everybody moved over here to this group on this anniversary. You know, I just thank you for this group this morning. Please forgive me. Thank you in the name of Jesus.
Well, put your hands together for the Aging Gracefully Ministry. We're so proud of what they do. Thank you all for what you do. And we heard you, Trustee Rogers, about those of us that should be sitting on this side. you know. And when I reach that age, I'm going to sit on this side. Amen. 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 God bless you for what you do. Today I've been given the task of introducing the speaker of the morning, my brother, my friend, my colleague, and one of the smoothest preachers I know. But he's truly a man of God. Amen. Reverend Ronald P. Waldon, Jr. He was born September 23rd, 1966 in Detroit, Michigan, where he accepted Christ as his Savior at an early age. In 1991, he accepted the Lord's call to become a minister. In 1992, he became licensed to preach God's word. Reverend Waldon was publicly ordained in the gospel ministry of Jesus Christ in 1997. Reverend Waldon earned his Bachelor of Religious Arts degree in Theological Studies from Logos Christian College in 2005. Reverend Waldon graduated with the highest of honors, summa cum laude, and I'm sure it was a thank you, Lordy, that went with that. Amen. Amen. And he holds a lifetime membership in Logos Christian College Alumni Association, where he was very active. Upon graduation from Logos, he participated in the Spiritual Renewal Institute workshop, served as facilitator in the NAACP Ford Motor Company Career Day and Youth Summit, participated in Baptist Missionary and Education Youth Auxiliary Workshops and District Revivals. That's a busy man. Reverend Waldon is currently pursuing his Master of Divinity from Shaw University, Raleigh, North Carolina. Amen. Go Bears. Amen, amen, amen. In 2008, Reverend Waldon served as the pastor of the First United Church of Christ in Franklinton, North Carolina, during his three-year pastorate. God bless the ministry. Prior to his pastoral call, Reverend Waldon served as the youth pastor right here at Macedonia New Life Church. Amen. From 2006 to 2008, Reverend Waldon also served as youth minister of the New Liberty Baptist Church in Detroit, Michigan. In December 2012, Reverend Waldon accepted the call of the pastorate of the Lakeview Missionary Baptist Church in Durham, North Carolina, and served until July 2021. Under Pastor Walden's leadership, ministries expanded and Lakeview Missionary Baptist Church grew spiritually and numerically. Pastor Waldon also demonstrated encouraging pastoral leadership during a global pandemic by implementing innovative workshop and teaching experiences to expand our witness not only to the disciples of Lakeview Missionary Baptist Church, but to the masses. Pastor Waldon and his lovely wife, Reverend Kimberly Ann Waldon, are the proud parents of one son, a graduate of East Carolina University, Greenville, North Carolina. Ronald Preston Waldon III. Amen. 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 They reside in Raleigh, North Carolina. But right now, we are proud to welcome you on behalf of Pastor Joel Stevenson and First Lady in their absence to Macedonia New Life Church. And after the praise team, the next voice you will hear will be the voice of Reverend Ronald Waldon. Amen? Amen. Amen. Y'all stretch your hands to the preacher and say, Pastor Waldon, preach the word. Pastor Waldon, preach the word. Amen. Hallelujah.
If I never see a smiling face, if
if I never breathe another breath or take another step, I want to say thank you. If I never speak another word, if I never sing another song to be heard, if I never see another sight or take another bite, I want to say thank you. Oh,
thank you for all that you've done thus far.
If I never see another day, if I never see a smiling face, if I never breathe another breath or take another step, I want to say thank you. If I never speak another word, if I never sing another song to be heard, if I never see another sight or take another bite, I want to say thank you. Oh,
thank you for all that you've done thus far.
Thank you. for all.
Thank you for all that you've done thus far.
Thank you for
being the God that you are.
There's nobody like you,
thank
Lord.
You for good on my I know you're
so
able.
I'm going to say
thank you.
Oh, nobody like you,
thank
people.
You for food on my
table.
I know
and
able.
I'm going to say
thank you.
How many of you know that he's still able? Eternal Father, we thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you once again how you allowed us as your children to come worship you in spirit and in truth. Father, we thank you, Lord, for what the songs that have been sung, the word that have been spoken. Now, Father, we pray that you have saturated your anointing in the hearts of your people, that they will receive the word of God. I snuck and read it where it says in John 3:30 that you increase and I decrease. So let the words of the mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord. You are my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Let every heart say amen, amen, and amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Privilege, amen, to be in the presence of you, amen. But most of all, it's an honor and a privilege to be in the presence of the Lord, amen. As I always say, it's good to be home, amen. I thank God for this opportunity to stand behind this sacred desk. I see that God's hand is still on the life of Macedonia. Amen. When I walked on the campus and came in, Brother Jay was right there at the door and he gave me a little tour. Amen. And I see that God is doing a new thing. As Isaiah 43:19 says, that he's doing a new thing. And it's an honor and a privilege again to be here. Again, I want to thank Dr. Stevenson, amen, and also his beautiful wife, amen. If you are by a camera or see a camera, just wave at them and let them know that we love them, amen, that we care for them, and that we are praying for them, amen. Again, I want to thank some of my disciples. I don't see them. Let me put on my glasses so I can see them. If they are here, amen. But if they are, we thank God for them. Also thank God for our son, amen, Master Ronald III, who's here from school. And also I want to thank my beautiful, loyal, devoted, and dedicated wife. The word already been read in your hearing, and I don't want to prolong the time. But I need you to do me a favor as the word had went forth. I just want to tap into one particular part of this verse, amen, and thank God for the praise and ministry. I just want to tap into one verse where it says that, and it says, but it gave light by the night of these so that the one that came near, amen, you don't need to sin, amen, amen. It's just I need to read it for my self-edification, amen. Where it says right there in 25, the last portion of the verse, it said that let us flee from the face of Israel, for the Lord fighteth for them against Egyptians. I need you to do me a favor. I need you to do me a favor. Look at your neighbor like they owe you some money. Amen. Look at them. There's no need to look at me because I don't owe you no money. But look at your neighbor like they owe you some money, like you know you're not going to get it back. But tell them these words, God will see you through. Now, I need you to say that with power. I need you to say it more prophetically. I need you to say it more convincingly to that same neighbor and tell him, God will see you through. Come on, give God a thunderous hand clap of praise like the devil's head is in between them. Amen. By letting the devil in hell know that God will see you through. God will. Reverend Wynn, see you through. Sister Rogers, God will see you through. Mother Chavis, God will see you through. Church, God will see you through. Is there in the Pentateuch of one of the five books of the Bible, what Moses, the inspiring words that he had written here in the book of Exodus, as we know to be the second book of the Bible in the Old Testament, it tells us of the departure of the Israelites coming out of the hands of slavery. Coming out of the hands of Pharaoh there in Egypt. Now heading to the promised land, and that God had secured for them a land that will flow with milk and honey. It is said that, my brothers and sisters, that God had, the children of Israel had handpicked them as a chosen people. And told them that he had a land, a place, that they can call their home. You praying? But as we notice here, that here in the book of Exodus, it speaks on their long, tedious journey. And I can say that in these 20 months that we have been living, many of us, Deaconess Lee, had been in some tedious journey. It is said, my brothers and sisters, that there was a long, tedious journey on how they went through some trials and some tribulation, like many of us, of how they had been tested and tempted on every side through temptation, like many of us. But while being on this tedious journey, even though they wanted to give up when the time has got rough. I know many of us wanted to give up when the time have got rough. Note that that's not the time when you need to give up. Because even though, my brothers and sisters, it get hard sometimes, you got to learn how to trust in God. No matter what you're going through, no matter what you are dealing with, know that God will see you through. He'll see you through your journey from your slavery to your promise. But through all of what you have went through these last 20 months, know that God was still there to see you through. Do I got any witnesses out there? God was there to see you through. All through your ups and downs, God was there to see you through. Even through your failures, God was there to see you through. Even through all of your disappointment, God was there to see you through. Even in your disobedience, talk to me, somebody, and your rebellious against him, God still managed to see you. Oh, it didn't look good at times, but God still sought you through.
You didn't know how you was going to make it from day to day, but God had sought you through. You didn't know how you was going to make it from paycheck to paycheck, but God had sought you through. Even though you were laid off, let go from your job, but through it all, God was right there providing your every need. Talk to me, somebody. So go ahead and tell your neighbor, he was there, he was there. That's the wrong neighbor. Tell another neighbor, he was there all the time. Just like we see here, my brothers and sisters, here with the children of Israel. God been right there all the time providing for them. He provide for them through their journey of experience, where it is similar to ours on how we too had to struggle and had to go through some things because of what we had been through, because of the defiance against God. But thanks be to God that he looked beyond all of our faults when we were so defiant and rebellious against God and met every one of our needs. But with the children of Israel, these were people of God who were selected by God of being the chosen people. Know that they had imparted and he had imparted his spirit upon them as being the nation, the chosen generation, as being the royal priesthood and the holy nation to help them lead others along. It was said that their trip from Egypt to Canaan have cost them 40 years when it should only just taken 3 days. Let me say it one more time, because their trip from Egypt to Canaan have taken them 40 years when it should have taken them only 3 days. But I can tell you why, and I can put a pin here, the reason why, for some of us, why it have taken 40 years instead of 3 days is because we didn't listen to the voice of God. Yeah, talk to me. When we were in trouble, we were too impatient to do what God has called us to do. We were too impatient, my brothers and sisters, end up taking shortcuts and find ourselves in situation taking longer than what it had expected. It said that the children of Israel was in the wilderness for 40 years when it should only just taken them 3 days. Now tell me, how many of you were challenged by a specific order from God, but you decided to do it your way? Talk to me. And while being impatient with God, what could have taken 3 days have now turned to being 40 days, all because you wanted to do it your way. When it says that they that wait in Isaiah 40 and 31 upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They will mount up with wings as eagle. They will run and not be weary. They will walk and not faint. Talk to me, somebody. Go tell your neighbor, God will see you through. Oh, just when you thought you was at your lowest spot, God will see you through. Just when you thought he was right there by your side, God will see you through. When you thought it was at your last, when you thought that you was unexpected for him to come, God was right there to see you through. When you thought it was all over, God was right there to see you through. But you got to learn how to wait on him. Because the Bible declares that the Israelites' journey had them for 40 years, when knowingly it should have taken them only 3 days. But they had so many excuses. Like many of us, Brother Darrell, have so many excuses during this pandemic. They had so many excuses on while they were on the way. They had dealt with my brother seven and sisters, seven different wilderness experience that they had to deal with while folk was going through what they were going through. Oh, they were going through some similarity to what we were going through, because a lot of them was hungry. And we see it in our day, in this time, in these 20 months, that people are being hungry. Talk to me, somebody. People were angry because nowadays you see folk being angry at one another. You can't even say good morning to someone without them being angry with you. They were in a wilderness experience, tired of being sick and tired to make it legal. Oh, my brothers and sisters, they still were complaining. Why, Moses, why would you leave us back in Egypt? Why to bring us here in the wilderness to die? Oh, my beloved brothers and sisters, can you see the similarities of us being just like the children of Israel? Who was complaining like some of us? Who never been satisfied? Talk to me. But all of the thoughts and the distractions that was going on around them, God never ceased to bless them. After all the distractions that is going on, God never ceased to see them through. But as we move on, let's look at chapter 24 of Joshua. When you get a chance at your leisure time, read the book of Joshua, the 24th chapter. Amen. Because it's some similarity of them and the children of Israel. It is brought from Joshua to their attention as a reminder of what the Lord has done for them. And sometimes, every time, now and then, we need to be reminded how good God has been to us. Oh, it's right there in chapter 24, Joshua, right there in verse 6 and 7, of how we are so forgetful, of how we are so ungrateful on how God has sought us through some things. Talk to me. Watch what he says in verse 6 and 7. He tells us how he made a way for them out of escape from the pursuing of the Egyptian army. He made a way of escape for some of you, for when you were in bondage, out from your enemies. The Bible says that he had made a way of escape of the Egyptian army as they were making their exit out of Egypt, headed into the promised land. Joshua told him, remember. Remember the Red Sea experience. Sometimes you got to go back and see how God had delivered you from some stuff. Sometimes you got to go back on how God had delivered you from that domestic violence. Sometimes you got to go back and see how God had healed your body when you was on your deathbed. Sometimes you got to go back on how that husband had walked out on you, how that a wife wasn't no good. Sometimes you got to go back, talk to me, go back and see how he had made a way out of no way. Sometimes you got to go back by turning some of your things and your situation around. God had turned your situation around because it's right there in Genesis 50 and 20 where he said what the devil had meant for evil. Do I got any witness in here? God had turned your situation around. So Joshua said, go back. Yeah, we have to go back. We got to go back. Because a lot of times we want to get up, get out, and get on. Sometimes, Sister Sonetta, Reverend Sonetta, we want to get on without asking for direction from God. We want to get on without praying and asking God where to go. We want to get up, get out, and get on. But Joshua said, in your Red Sea experience, learn how to go. Joshua said, learn how to go back to your Red Sea experience to win. The doctor, when he had said that he done all that he can do. I'd read it in Isaiah 53 and 5, where he said that even though the doctor done all he can do, God said that we was wounded for his transgression. We was bruised for his iniquity. The chastisement of his peace was upon him, and with our stripes, we are healed. So tell your neighbor, go back, go back. Go back to your Red Sea experience. Joshua said, go back. Go back and see how he delivered you on can see here in Exodus, the 14th chapter, that the children of Israel were in great danger. Like we see in this Delta variant, this COVID-19 that we are in. We are in some serious danger. Like we see here with the children of Israel, they were in danger because Pharaoh, but watch what happened. Pharaoh had released them from bondage, but in releasing them, he changed his mind. Oh, in releasing them, he changed his mind. The cliche is that you never miss anything until it's gone. Talk to me, somebody. But even though he had changed his mind, we know that all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord. Here's why, because all things, Matthew 19 and 26, work together, and all things are impossible. But Pharaoh, my brothers and sister, changed his mind. He changed his mind and pursued after them. And the Bible says that the Red Sea was in front of them. Yeah. And the sweltering mountains of bill collectors and folk that's on your nerves. Both sweltering mountains was on both sides. And the Egypt of the army, your enemies, are pursuing behind you. Know that no matter what your circumstances are, no matter what you've been dealing with, no matter what your circumstances is, no matter how hard it seems to be, know that my God is still able. My God that I serve will see you through, because I know him to never leave you nor forsake you. Has anybody been there in a situation to where your enemy thought he had you right where he wanted you? And you decided, and he decided to let you go. But know that it wasn't by his power nor by his might that let you go. But it was by the power of God. Because what the devil meant for evil, God turned it around for your good. God already turned around that situation around. In other words, he came to see you. He came to see you. He came to meet you. He came to see you right where you are, all because of your faithfulness. Though he had slain me, yet will I trust him. I said, though he had slain me, yet will I trust him. Do I got any yet folks out there? I said, do I got any yet folks out there that know when the devil said no, God said yes. Talk to me, somebody. That when the doctor had shook his head and said, I done all that I could do, God still said yes. Do I got any yet folk out there by the waving of your hand? Do I got any yet folks out there that's viewing this telecast that's going to keep on trusting in the Lord until you die? Do I got any yet folks in here that knowing that the Red Sea, after all that you have lost, you got mountains of hellish folk on both sides of you. Pharaoh armors behind you. Your enemies chasing you, trying to kill you, trying to bring you down, trying to hold you back. You got to learn how to say, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. That's why you got to believe God and know that he'll supply your every need. In spite of what it looks like right now, know that no weapon gonna form. But God always seemed to be right in the midst. Somebody gonna shout on this one. God always seemed to be right in the midst when we messed up. Talk to me, somebody. God always, Deacon Oliver, seemed to always be in the midst when we mess up. It seems like he's always there, yeah, to pick up the pieces when we had done wrong. It seems like he's always there to bring light into your darkness when we don't want to do right. Talk to me, somebody. He's always been there when we least expect him to be. And many of us should have been dead and gone a long time ago. But God's grace kept us. And it's not because you deserve it. Talk to me, somebody. But it's just like God to come and see you through. Because ours was one that always had some type of problems. I was always in some type of trouble, church, myself. But he kept on seeing me through. I kept on doing wrong when I should have been doing right. But God always kept on seeing me through. And one thing, my brothers and my sisters, I can say is that every time I knew to do right. Paul said that evil was always present. And even being present sometime, I just don't feel like doing that which was right. But sometimes, somehow, and some way, God always hear my voice. And he always pity my every groan. He always reached all the way down to where I was. I know sometimes it seems as though God is not there. But encourage your neighbor. Wave at somebody on the airway and let them know that he was there. He was there all the time. On some of the stuff that he had brought you through. That's something right there that you ought to thank God for. Because he was there. It looks like everything was over, but know that God was there. If you look back over your life on some of the stuff that he had saved you from and carried you through when making the wrong decision, that's something right there that you can shout about. Go ahead and wave at somebody and tell them that was God that was keeping you. He was keeping you from harm's way. It could have been nobody but Jesus that brought you from a mighty long way. Because while you were yet born in sin and engaging ourselves in the sins of the world, the Bible says that Christ came to see about you. The Bible says that Christ seek and sought you through. Here is the reason why, because he died on one Friday. Yeah, and they hung him on that rugged cross. They pierced him in the side. But the Bible says that he didn't say a mumbling word. But all he said is, Father, yeah, forgive them for what they know, not what they do. I stopped by to tell somebody he had borrowed tune. He went down into hell and had a 3-night revival. But when he came back with all power in his hand. And when he came back, he let us know that he will see us through. And I thank God for Jesus, because when I was lost in sin, he came to see about me. It's good to know, even though I was in sin, he came and washed my sins away. I stopped by to tell you, Macedonia New Life Church, may the Lord bless you real good. Come on, Dr. Tiffany, let's dance. But I need you to do me a favor. I dare you to wave at somebody, wave at them, and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, neighbor, I thank God that the bondage that you were in didn't destroy you. When you look back over your life and all he brought you through, I thank God that he didn't destroy your life, but he destroyed every mountain, every building, everything that got in your way, that's been holding you back. I thank God that he was right there all the time. I thank God he brought you through the miry clay. I thank God that he brought you from where you were. I thank God he healed your body, because a weeping may endure it for a night, but joy come in the morning. How many of you know that joy come in the morning? Have I got any witness in here that know if it wasn't for the blood of Jesus, where would many of us be? Tell your neighbor, where would we be? How many of you know that God will give you strength when you're weak? How many of you know that God will lift you up when you're down? How many of you know that God will deliver you when you're down? I stopped by to tell somebody that God had destroyed everything that the enemy had thrown your way. So there's no need to be weary in your well-doing, because God will come see you through. So don't walk around with your head down. Don't walk around having a pity party. Don't walk around being down, because God said he'll give you what you need. Now do me a favor, wave at somebody and tell them, God will, God will, God will see you through. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Say yeah, say yeah, say yeah, say yeah, say yeah. Won't he do it? Now go ahead and tell that neighbor, I see that God had been good to you. I see that God had made a way for you. I see that God had brought you out. Tell that neighbor, keep rising, keep shining, because God is not through blessing you. How I know? Because early Sunday morning, he got up, he got up, he got up to let us know that everything is going to be all right. Now in the search, the Bible said, look to the hills for which cometh your help. Know that your help would always come from the Lord. I feel a shout going on. I feel a breakthrough. I feel deliverance. I see God is delivering somebody. The dance floor is open. I dare you to let the devil know, ain't nothing is gonna separate me from the love of God. Ain't he all right? Say yeah, say yeah, say God will see about me. God will see about me. God will see about me. The dance floor is open. God will see about me. He tried to kill you, but God will see about me. He tried to destroy my family, but God will see you through. He will see you through. If you know he will, say yeah. Come on, don't play with it. God will see you through. God will see you through. There's no need to sit down on God. God will see you through. I feel a shout. I feel a shout.
God had delivered somebody. God has set some folks free. I feel a shout. Well, don't stop praising them now. Don't stop praising them now. If you believe that God will see you through, you need to say hallelujah. You need to say thank you, Jesus. If you know that it's because of God, if you know that God was with you, even when you went through your deepest and your darkest hours, somebody need to say hallelujah right now. God will see you through. God will see you through. God will see you through. Hallelujah. If you believe, you need to stand to your feet right now and praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Because if it had not been for the Lord on your side, where would you be? If it had not been for the Lord on my side, I don't know where I would be. God will see you through. God will. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Put glad hands together for this preacher today, Reverend Ronald Waldon. What a word, what a word. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. What a word. Didn't that man preach? Didn't he bring a word from on high? Oh, put glad hands together for our speaker this morning. I don't know about you, but I heard him. I know that God will see me through. I know that he has seen me through. He will see you through. All you got to do is lean into him. All you got to do is depend on him. All you got to do is trust him. All you got to do is believe in him. And if you do, God will see you through. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. As we prepare to go down from this place, once again, on behalf of Reverend Dr. Joel Stevenson, First Lady Brenda, we'd like to thank Pastor Ronald Waldon for a word from on high today. And while we are yet standing, those of you that desire to give your life to Christ today, those of you in the sanctuary, those of you that are watching at home, there's a form on the screen right now. If you desire salvation, if you desire prayer, please fill out the form and someone will get back with you. Believe me, it may not be today, but one of the disciples will get back with you. Give your life to Christ.
give your life to Christ. Today is a day that he's made, and he's waiting for you. Amen. 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 Now's the time. Now's the time to come to Jesus. If you know that Jesus Christ is the way, now is the time. Tomorrow's not promised.
Promise keeper, light in the darkness.
So today is the day. In the name of Jesus.
That is who you are.
If you believe that God is a way maker.
Way
maker. If you believe.
Miracle worker.
That Jesus Christ walked this earth as a man, that he died on our behalf, that he rose again on that third day. Now is the time.
You are here. You're moving in the midst.
Don't wait. Don't wait. Come to Jesus. Don't wait. Come today, brother. Come today, sister. Don't wait.
I worship you. And you're turning lives around.
Hallelujah.
I worship you.
We worship you today, God. We worship you today, Lord.
I worship
you. We lift you up. We praise your holy name.
Way maker.
Way maker.
We trust and believe that you're a way maker today, Lord. If you know. If you know that you know that you know, today is the day. Come on. Hallelujah. God bless you.
I worship 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 you.
You are here.
You are here.
You are here.
And you're mending broken hearts.
Hallelujah.
I worship you.
I worship you. Yes, yes, yes. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for being that way maker, God.
My God, that is who you are.
We call you way maker.
Way maker.
Miracle promise keeper.
Promise keeper. Light in the darkness.
My God,
that is who you are.
You believe it. Say hallelujah.
That is who you are.
That is who you are, Lord.
That is who you
are to me. You're a way maker. Hallelujah. Yes, 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 yes. That is who you are, Lord.
Even when I can't see it, you're working.
Yeah.
And even when I can't feel it,
even
you're working.
Even when I can't see it.
You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never
you
stop
You just keep on
working.
Keeping on, Lord.
Even when I can't see it, you're working. And even when I can't
feel it,
you're working. You never stop.
You never stop,
you
Lord.
Never stop working.
Aren't you glad God never
you
stops?
Never stop.
Aren't you glad he keeps on keeping on? Aren't you glad he's a God that
even
never sleeps?
When I
hallelujah.
Can't see it,
even, hallelujah. When,
even when I can't feel it, you're working.
You never stop.
You never stop.
You never,
you never stop.
Stop
working.
You never stop.
You never stop.
You never stop.
Stop.
might can't see him, but he's still working. You might not know it, but he's still working. He never stops. He never stops. Oh, he never stops. Hallelujah.
You never stop. Even when I can't see it, you work.
You never stop.
Even when I can't feel it, you work.
You never stop.
You never stop.
You never stop.
You never stop working.
You never stop.
You never stop.
Yes. Yes, 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 yes. If you believe God is a way maker today, wave your hands. Because he never stops. He never stops. Even when you can't see him, he's working. Amen, 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 amen. As we prepare to go down from this place, remember to follow the directions of the ushers as you leave. We're still in a pandemic, so we want to still be socially distant. Amen. As they get to your row, they will lead you out. Amen. Once again, we stop to thank Reverend Ronald P. Walden for that wonderful word from on high this morning. Oh, put glad hands together. What a word, what a word, what a word. Amen and amen. Be mindful of the announcements for the week, Dawn Seekers Prayer, Tuesdays at 6 a.m. Be sure to join in to hear a wonderful word. The office will be closed on Monday, November 29th. Amen? Amen, amen, amen. Grace Encounter. Grace Encounter. For the grieved and the brokenhearted. Amen. Govern yourselves accordingly. November, there are so many things that we are praying for in the month of November. The American Diabetes Association Awareness Month, Lung Cancer Awareness Month, Pancreatic Cancer Awareness Month. Be mindful of all these illnesses, all these things that are going on in our lives. We pray for anyone that has to deal with any of these things. Amen? Amen. Once again, in the absence of our pastor, we lift him up. Continue to pray for him and First Lady as they continue their vacation. We bless you, sir. We miss you, sir. We look forward to having you back behind this sacred desk. So as we prepare to go down from this place, let us pray. Father God, we thank you for Jesus. We ask that as we leave this place, that you won't leave our presence. Oh, God, give us traveling mercy. And as we continue throughout this week, Father God, bless like you've never blessed before. And allow us to come back again to praise your holy name at Macedonia New Life Church. We thank you. We love you. Go in peace. Just know that God loves you. We love you. And there's nothing you can do about it in the words of our pastor. Amen. Amen. Have a wonderful week.
Waymaker, miracle worker, Ronald.